At Goa IT Day, Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar said IT policy aims to bring down bureaucratic red tapism and also it would go a long way in making the state digitally empowered. During a panel discussion, Chief Minister stressed on reverse brain drain for the state. Here's more. Only the opportunities are required, otherwise we would have Mangeshkar staying in Goa. They had to migrate because of lack of opportunities. Parrikar said, referring to creating right opportunities for youth to ensure they stay back in the state instead of migrating to other places for better jobs. Parrikar also stressed that IT policy aims to bring down bureaucratic red tapism. Here are the excerpts from the panel discussion that took place at IT Day event.
Such a small place has produced talent beyond its strength. And this exists for IT also. Only opportunity is required. Otherwise, we would have Mangeshkars in staying in Goa. Why did they have to migrate? Because opportunities were lacking. We have a lot of IT talent which is in Bangalore, driving the engine in Bangalore or Pune. Pune and Bangalore are favorite destination of Goan IT sector. We need to have the reverse brain drain for the state. My target would be let my talent stay in the state and develop the state and become an industrial as well as IT hub. In IT sector at least, you will be seeing the policy tomorrow. We have worked out arrangement by which all the bureaucratic red tapism is virtually brought down to a very small component. So if someone is promised something, this is true for industries also. We are also coming out with industrial policy. For whatever is promised has to be delivered to him in reasonable time, with reasonable energy and with very less hassles. I think the policy itself ensures many of these things. So that once you are through, like that certificate which has been issued for a startup, it entitles him for a policy initiatives which are benefits which are there. And those can be cleared by one single committee, that's all. Then the rest, it's no file has gone to the finance department, all those things have been bypassed. And we have created special account so that once it's approved, the money comes directly through the department without any further assets.
I recommend to Minister to have a Goa Elevate 50 like Karnataka does, where you call all startups, young startups to come, give an idea, and the best startups, top 10 maybe a year, get 25 lakhs for marketing as a grant. And a grant, then a seed fund, then a venture fund. Of course, Goa cannot spend so much of money. They can be a catalyst. Catalyst means you put up 25-30% for the first 500 startups, spend maybe over the next 5 years, something like 250-300 crore, which is not much for Goa. And you became a catalyst to get more money in. Now, money will come in provided you know how to market. Money will come in when you have technology. Money will come in when you have innovation. But you need the innovation to come up. And that's where Goa has to help. Once they come up to a certain stage, then the system will take care of everything. So I think this, because today, let me tell you, people outside haven't heard of Goa as an IT destination. We always know Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Delhi, Gurgaon, etc. But we don't know Goa. Now, I was pleasantly surprised to see that 270 startups and there are nearly 3,000 people. And what is much more happy thing for me is to learn that 35 to 40% of employees in the top two companies of Goa are women. That's a very high percentage. It shows the kind of society Goa is. And Goa is a global village. So in every village, you could have 10 startups. They could take old bungalows and set up shop there and start working.
The startup policy got launched in April. From April, we are already having a Goa Angel Network already formed. Srinivas Dempo is chairing the Goa Angel Network, which is powered by Mumbai Angel Network. EDC already has kept funds to the tune of 500 lakhs for seed funds. We are the government schemes and policies which are lined up from the startup per se are very clear and very simple to avail. What I feel today is a challenge in Goa is the exposure from a startup who's got innovation, who's got ideas to get into an entrepreneurship model. The bridge of a person who wants to do something has a problem of how to get that thing. So I believe a lot of we have started with the startup yatra. We are having boot camps. We are having a lot of aggressive campaigns happening post the IT policy on the startup. So this will give a lot of booster at the college, at the university levels, where we will start identifying new innovations, new people. A talent pool in Goa has never been less.
Goa IT Day is a part of focused initiative to promote innovation and encourage entrepreneurial investment in the state so that Goa can be counted among top 25 startup destinations in Asia by 2025. The IT policy would be formally unveiled by Union Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad on Sunday. Our video journalist Irshad Sheikh at Chama Prasad Mukherjee Stadium in Bamboli.